A glorious Easter to everyone. Good morning. Good morning. We gather in this Easter season rejoicing that Christ is risen and with us. We welcome Father Eads from the, which diocese, New Albany? Albany, New York, upstate New York, is with us. He had a wedding here at Emmanuel yesterday and is celebrating with us. We welcome you this day. As we gather in prayer, let us come together before the Lord as we pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace and the peace of our risen Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
In our gospel today, Jesus gives us an important instruction. Remain in me. Remain in me. In the waters of baptism, we are grafted to Jesus. We are the branches. He is the vine. He sustains us in our every need. And yet we know we wander from him. Through our sin, we're cut off from him, but he welcomes us back through his most precious blood, leading us to new life. Brothers and sisters, as we gather in prayer this Easter season, let us ask pardon and peace for our sin and rejoice in God's merciful love, Jesus who heals us through his precious blood. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie Christe, eleison.
Christe,
Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus, omne voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agimus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus pater omnipotens, Domine Deus
stain, filius patris, vitolis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, vitolis peccata mundi, suscis et deprecationem nostram, qui sedes ad dexterum patris, miserere nobis, quoniam tum solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu, in gloria Dei patris.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the apostles, but they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved about freely with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with the Hellenists, but they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord, and with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before Him in whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from Him whatever we ask, because we keep His commandments and do what pleases Him. And His commandment is this: we should believe in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as He commanded us. Those who keep His commandments remain in Him, and He in them. And the way we know that He remains in us is from the Spirit He gave us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to His disciples, "I am the true vine, and My Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in Me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, He prunes so that it will bear more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in Me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remain on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in Me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in Me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without Me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in Me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in Me and My words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is My Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become My disciples." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
If I had to summarize the readings today and put the overarching message of all of them into a single sentence, it would be, put your faith where your mouth is. Put your faith where your mouth is. Now, of course, St. John, as we might well expect of an apostle, puts this much more eloquently in the second reading where he says, "Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth." The point is, talk is cheap. Our Lord's death on Calvary cost him dearly. It cost him everything. And so we should expect living out a grace-filled life will cost us something too. And in point of fact, it will cost us everything to be perfect as our Heavenly Father is perfect, as our Lord told us we must be. But it is that very grace he freely gives us that enables us to do so. If we stay close to him, if we remain a branch on the vine that is our Lord, if his words remain in us by us acting on them, we will bear much fruit. But we fail so often, don't we? We become discouraged. We are so weak, so fickle, so fearful of pain and suffering. This is what St. John means when he was talking about our hearts condemning us. But Jesus knows our weakness. He knows our hearts. In the book of Hebrews, we read, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way and yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and find grace for timely help." God, as St. John said, is greater than our hearts. His grace, if we do not give in to discouragement, will enable us to have a heart like his, a heart like our Lord's. St. John began this reading very tenderly, by calling us children, for that is who we are before our loving Father. And the key to reassuring our hearts, which may often condemn us, is to remain, as St. Therese of the Child Jesus said, whose statue is back behind us by the Pietà in the back of the church, by the way. The key to reassuring our hearts is to remain little before God. And St. Therese goes on to explain what remaining little means. She writes, "To remain little is to recognize our nothingness, to expect everything from the good God, and not to be too much afflicted by our faults. For little children fall often, but are too small to hurt themselves." Little children are inherently humble and unassuming, aren't they? St. Therese's little way, the way of doing small things with great love, is the way of spiritual childhood. It is the way of being humble and unassuming in all the good we do, referring any merit to the good Lord. And when we suffer trials and humiliations in life, referring that to the cross. When we do this, we can have great confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask. Let's not pass over this promise too quickly. If we have the heart of a child, a heart that does not condemn us, a heart like our Lord's, St. John tells us God will give us whatever we ask. Imagine being St. John. Imagine receiving whatever we ask for. What would we ask our Lord for? Health? Money to pay bills or to help our parents or siblings or the poor? Would we ask for a job, for political, religious, or social unity? All are worthy causes, all charitable and even essential. Well, what did St. John, in fact, do with the power he had to get anything he asked for? After all, if anyone believed in Jesus and loved others as Jesus taught us to, St. John was certainly among that number. For his part, after our Lord's ascension, St. John suffered great persecution under the Roman Emperor Domitian. The Romans tried to kill him by boiling him in oil, but he was miraculously spared, so they exiled him to a barren island called Patmos. He went on to endure much hardship. He did not enjoy any political or worldly power or benefits. He was not rich in the eyes of the world. But this suited St. John just fine, for he had a heart like our Lord's. You see, having a heart like our Lord's means our hearts have turned away from desiring what the world does, for grasping at what the world does, for seeking happiness in the things of this world. This is what the Father prunes from us, the idea that happiness lies in anything, in anyone but him, in anything but being in his will for us. This is how we will bear much fruit, how we will come to have a heart like our Lord's. This confidence, this belief in the words of our Lord means more than merely intellectual assent. It means trusting Jesus enough to carry out his words in our lives. Think of it this way. The difference between a belief that is merely intellectual assent and truly trusting Jesus is the difference between believing a trapeze artist can walk across a high wire with no net and letting him carry you while he does it. If our belief in Jesus does not manifest itself in our actions, perhaps it's really nothing more than intellectual assent. St. John also said that we must love one another in deed and in truth. Truly loving in this way is tough, really tough. That eminent philosopher, Linus Van Pelt, from the cartoon strip Peanuts, once observed, "I love mankind. It's people I can't stand." Following that same kind of thought, Father Williams of the Legionaries of Christ observed, "It's much easier to love humanity than to love the greasy guy sitting next to you on the bus or plane, or the driver who cuts you off in traffic. It's easier to love people far away or to love classes of people like the poor, the starving in Ethiopia, or the homeless, rather than loving the flesh and blood people we meet every day." St. Paul thought he was loving God when he was persecuting the church, but he allowed God to prune him in a radical way and began to truly love Jesus, to truly love as Jesus did. To love as Jesus loved him. He asked for a heart like Jesus, a heart willing to love like Jesus did, a heart willing to suffer like Jesus did, a heart not focused on his own comfort or well-being, but on the salvation of souls. When with childlike trust we humbly ask for a heart like Jesus has, when we're willing to be pruned by the Father of all that is not like him, then we truly know we're believing in him and what believing in him really means. By this is our Heavenly Father glorified. By this we will bear much fruit and become his disciples.
Gathered as children of God, let us now profess our beliefs. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, the Lord nurtures us in love. Let us bring our prayers before him, trusting that his love is all we need.
That the Holy Spirit may continue to nurture the church and allow her disciples to bear good fruit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the ends of the earth may turn to the Lord for justice he has shown, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Father may prune the sins, fears, and bad habits that keep us from growing in his love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the fellowship of this faith community may continue to be built up with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the poor souls in purgatory, especially those who have no one else to pray for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parishioners of our family of parishes for which this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the evil of contraception, abortion, and euthanasia, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts and those written in our book of Saint Monica. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, you tend us as a grower cares for his vineyard. Grant us all we need to flourish for your glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Omnibus, Deus Domini, You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by this same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We have a few announcements. Please join us for the final session in Exploring the Eucharist series today at 1 p.m. here in the church. Lunch will be provided prior to the talk over in the school building. Father Patrick will be giving a talk on Eucharist and evangelization. Next Saturday, May 4th, Emmanuel will have a Mass with May crowning at 10 a.m. All are welcome. Come and honor the Virgin Mary in this month dedicated to her. And finally, the St. Gaspar family of parishes will have a confirmation Mass for all six parishes on Sunday, November 3rd at 1 p.m. If you have a child 12 years or older who you wish to receive the sacrament, please contact Brother Matt at the parish office.
This week, Archbishop Schnur had surgery for a flare-up of Crohn's disease. He's been in the hospital. The surgery went very well. He's recuperating now, so please keep him in your prayers as he recovers from his surgery. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.